I grew up in love. Family was all around. I went to church most Sunday mornings, my faith I'd thought I found. You see, I never ditched school or talked back to my teachers. My grades were always good, to perfection I was always reaching. I puttered along in this perfect little life. I never really had too much anger, angst, or strife. I worked hard and I studied to be the best that I could be, always reaching towards the highest point that I could see. Straight A's in school, Letterman's Club, and dance. As a freshman, I even had a senior as a boyfriend, just a little PG romance. I was never really into sex, drugs, or rock and roll. I wasn't a bad kid, but I guess boredom eventually took its toll. I was voted by my class most likely to succeed. Look at all I'd done, right? All by myself, just me. My voice got so loud it pushed out all the sound. I didn't seek anymore. I was good with what I'd found. I woke up one morning and thought I didn't feel God's hand, so I did what any child would do. I ran. I dove face first into a life full of sin. I turned my back on my families, my friend and kin. I ran so fast I didn't see that brick wall up ahead, as silly me. I thought I was the one who led. You see, I make my own decisions and I make the rules to this game. I did what I wanted, anything in my own name. The rain started trickling down so slow at first, but my head was above water and I didn't quench that thirst. Then it started falling harder and my resentment grew, but my head was still above water and I'm a strong swimmer. I thought, I don't need you. So paddling and treading day by day, one day at a time in my own way, slowly getting tired and trying to pull through. Again, I shouted louder, I don't want you. Unbeknownst to me, the tide was rising higher and I was about to be consumed like a frog in a pot of boiling water. You saw your daughter drowning and gasping for air, and through an undeserved act of love, came because you cared. Drowning in that water on my very last breath, a hand reached down to me and gave me rest. You see, little did I know that he was there the whole time, but he wanted me to bow down and let him shine. He gave his son's life for a sinner like me so that through my transgressions and human afflictions, I'm free. I have a warrior on my side, one who commands the nations, who gives us freedom in him, not through worldly sensations. So when you have those moments when you're walking alone, you have to realize that his whole plan isn't shown. There's a reason and a purpose, and it goes back to him. He didn't create you or your life on a whim. It was deliberate, intentional, a calculated creation. Your face belonged to him before the formation of nations. He gifted the spider to spin 3 different kinds of silk, whales to swim, birds to fly. He even gave us cows to milk. He took so much care to create this place. You think he took a break on your day with your face? No. He rose up and he said, I want you. My son, my daughter, desire me too. Love unconditionally and praise my name. Accept me as your Lord and Savior, and you will never be the same. His hand reaches down and he snatches us from the fire. Our hearts, our souls, he's the only buyer. He is the sole creator of grace, and the creator doesn't bail. Many are the plans in a man's heart, but it is the Lord's purpose that prevails. So when you're feeling shattered and broken and covered in sin, there's only one place to look, to him.